So, okay guys, let's talk something about chronic osteomyelitis. It was a recent AIIMS November 2018 image-based MCQ. I got a request how these three structures they look like on x-rays. Now, when do you call a osteomyelitis chronic? The hallmark for a chronic osteomyelitis is basically a sequestrum, right? And we all know what is a sequestrum, we all know the definition, but how it looks like, we should know that also, right? Sequestrum is basically a dead bone. Right, it is a dead bone which is surrounded by granulation tissue. Okay, so you should know very well how it looks like, which is surrounded by granulation tissue. So how will that look like? Have a look on this femur. Basically, now if you see under this femur here, under the circle that I have just drawn, you can see a white projection of the bone. Can you all appreciate that? This is what you call a sequestrum. So this white piece inside the circle I have just drawn is what you call a sequestrum, which is now a dead bone. Why does it appears dense? Dense means why it is white similar to a normal bone. You can see the density of the sequestrum is almost similar to the normal bone. Why is that so? It is simply because there is no demineralization. What does that mean basically? When this bone was alive, there was a continuous blood flow into the piece of bone, and therefore there was a continuous exchange of minerals. Now once the bone is dead, it simply means now there is no more blood supply, and therefore whatever minerals were there, now they are trapped there only. That is what sequestrum is. Second important structure that we should know in a chronic osteomyelitis foci is an involucrum. Right, what does a involucrum means? See, involucrum is basically a reactive new bone formation. Now, how will new bone formation look like? Will that be white or black? That will be obviously white. Now, if you see this image again, once again, see this all white density structure here, all white dense. This is all basically the involucrum. And why we call this involucrum? See the central part. This is the AP view. Don't get confused. The same x-ray, the AP view, and this one is the lateral view. Right? So don't get confused in that. So in AP view, in lateral view, basically you saw the sequestrum over here. When I see the AP view, I can see the density over here and density over here, double cross. It is increased. It is suggestive of a high periosteal reaction. In fact, you can see the bone is also expanded here. That means there is already a new bone formation. This all white that you see under this circle is what you call an involucrum. That is a reactive new bone formation. Now, this sequestrum, as we said, it is surrounded by granulation tissue, and there is a new bone formation all around. What this granulation tissue or what this infective tissue will do, it will keep on pressurizing the involucrum, right? The new bone, it will keep on pressurizing the new bone, and therefore, from wherever the new bone ruptures, the involucrum, it opens up to give space for the granulation tissue to move out, is what you call a cloaca. This hole that you see, aperture, is what you call a cloaca. So cloaca are apertures in involucrum. And how they are created? They are created because of pressure of the granulation tissue over the involucrum, that is a reactive new bone formation. Right? So you should remember how the sequestrum look like. It will be as dense as a normal bone. Density is same as normal bone. Don't forget this one. It is same, or in fact it is sometime more denser than the surrounding bone. Now this cloaca is an aperture. I'll show you one more example, so it will be much easier for you to understand. Now see this. This is another image taken from Google, although. Now where is the sequestrum here? See this. This little toe, the fifth metatarsal, it has got an infection. This white piece that you see is what you call a sequestrum. Right? Once you see the sequestrum, have a look all around. There is an increase in the density everywhere around this cavity. This increase in density, new bone formation, is what you call involucrum. And now you can easily see there is a breach here. There is a breach here in the bone. This is what you call the cloaca, through which the granulation tissue will move out. Right? The granulation tissue will move out through the cloaca from here. Now, this is the soft tissue shadow. Just give me a moment. Okay, this is a soft tissue shadow. You all can appreciate, and you can see that there is a breach in the soft tissue also. This is a sinus on the skin, right? So often asked question to you is about sequestrum, involucrum, and cloaca. and the malignancy of the sinus tract. This is the sinus which is opening over the skin.